Can you explain how CSS3 is different?
I'd start by saying it is one increment higher than CSS2.
I know the number went up. What did they actually change?
CSS3 added a lot of new properties that were not in CSS2, like background clips, border radius, border images, font stretching and hanging punctuation.
I suppose this is not a good time for a hanging participle joke.
That's a part of speech, not really anything bad. What can get bad is when people try to use the new properties and don't use the associated longhand properties.
What is a longhand property?
Border, border right and other properties are shorthand. Longhand lets you specify it in greater detail like border top style, solid, before you define the other borders for the bottom and sides.
That seems like more work to specify longhand. Shorthand would say border, 1px solid black just once.
If you don't specify it longhand, the browser may apply its own indentation or border thickness, possibly even messing up your intended look.
Using that many properties can slow down the loading of a web page.
Conversely, you can control settings so the page isn't messed up when they load it.
How else is CSS3 different?
CSS3 added new values like a radial gradient or calling out an exact position for an image even as it is resized.
I think the biggest thing I've heard about was media queries.
Media queries let the content adapt to screen resolution, such as altering the size of pictures and text based on the screen size. It became a web standard in 2012.
Anything else I should know?
And you can specify multiple background images now.
One cat picture is enough for the background or watermark for now.
I think that's been a web standard for several years.
What? CSS?
No, cat pictures.